Hi, I'm Zach, and today we're going to talk about the Knipex Pliers Wrench. Stay tuned to find out more. Just as the name implies, the pliers wrench combine the smooth parallel jaws of a wrench with the gripping action of a pair of pliers. These are intended to replace a traditional crescent wrench, and they do that very well in most applications. When you first look at the pliers wrench, you might think they look a lot like a regular pair of channel locks, and they do. However, there are a couple key differences. From a technical standpoint, the grip ratio is one of those main differences. If we look at a pair of channel locks for a moment, we'll see that the grip ratio, that is the distance from the pivot to the end of the jaws versus the pivot to the end of the handles, is about, let's compare that distance, 1 to 3 to 1. On the other hand, if we look at the pliers wrench, we'll call the pivot point about where the center of that button is to the end of the cam here. And if you compare this distance to the length of the handle, you're going to get an about 11 to 1 grip ratio. So when you clamp down on a pair of pliers wrench, you're going to get a lot more force on the fitting than you do with a pair of channel locks. Add to that security the fact that they're smooth jaws versus the serrated jaws of a pair of channel locks, and you're going to mar up the fittings a lot less and keep them in better shape. Enough with the tech talk. How well do they actually work? I've had this pair for 3 or 4 years, so I feel like I can talk fairly well about them and how well they work versus a regular crescent wrench. Knipex advertises a ratcheting action. That is, you're gripping on the fitting, and when you go to remove the wrench to get another bite, instead of having to remove the wrench entirely and shift it around like you would with a crescent wrench, you can simply kind of let the handles fall free, pivot around, and re-grip for another bite. In many cases, it works exactly as advertised. If you're working in an engine bay, say on a car or truck where you just don't have much room to work, there's oftentimes not enough room to spread the handles. But usually when you're in that application, you're going to use a combination wrench anyway, not a crescent wrench or a pliers wrench. To be honest, the adjustment mechanism and the ratcheting action did take some getting used to. It's not as dead simple as a crescent wrench where you just have to slide your thumb. But once learned, it can be a lot faster than regular crescent wrench. One of the places that these really shine is when you're working on a fitting that's not mounted to anything. Say a fitting on the end of a hose, maybe it's a hydraulic hose, and you've got two wrenches, and if say you had two crescent wrenches, you'd be trying to hold the hose between your knees and grip on one end of the fitting with one wrench and then the other end of the fitting with another wrench and hope it doesn't slip out and all fall apart. With the gripping action of the pliers wrench, you can really hold one end of the fitting in place with one wrench and move the other wrench and get things done a lot faster and more efficiently. A few different variations that these come in are a version that has insulated handles for electrical work, as well as a comfort grip handle that just has a little more bulk and a little more cushion. I personally prefer the more streamlined look and feel of the simple red rubber dipped handles. They sell these in a handful of different sizes. I have the 5, 7, 10, and 12 inch. In addition to that, they also sell a 6 and a 16 inch. The 7, 10, and 12 are what I've found to be the most versatile. 12 is fairly big and can get a bite on a pretty big fitting. 7 is about the smallest that's still comfortable to hold. Not to confuse you with all these sizes, but the 5, I believe this is the 5, is handy for tight spaces, but to be honest, it's almost too small to get a good hold on, and the adjustment mechanism, while workable, is almost too small. I kind of fumble around with it. To recap, the pliers wrench are lighter, faster, and more secure than a traditional crescent wrench in many applications. However, if you're mostly using it for automotive work, a crescent wrench might be the better way to go. Really, a combination wrench is the best option, especially when working with nuts and bolts. In closing, if you're a plumber or just in the general maintenance trade, as I am, the Knipex pliers wrench are a good buy. My one regret is that when I first bought a pair, I was on the edge about whether to buy one or a few, or they sell a 3-pack, what should I do? Couldn't find anybody to really tell me about them, tell anybody that had any experience with them. So I just bought the 10-inch variety. I wish I had sprung for the 3-pack that includes the 7, the 10, and the 12, as those are now the sizes that I use most often. That's all for today. To see more videos just like this one, tap subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we upload. We'll see you next time.